this video, we are going to see the files, how to add data at the end of the file and displaying the data from a file, searching the particular letter word in a file, counting and changing the data in file, and inserting data in between the file, copying data from one file to another and deleting. See, first we are going to see how to append the data. We are opening the file student.txt in append mode, and we are getting runtime name and age. It will be written into the file student.txt. If you want to continue, we can give y. So continuously we can give the data and it will be stored like this. Next, displaying data using the read lines, we can read line by read and just to print like this from student.txt file. Using read method also we can display the data from a particular file. The difference between these two, read line should show the delimiter /t/n/t+n, but in a read function it won't show that. And next, to search the particular letters, here you are going to search the letter A is present in first.txt file or not. So here A means we can consider the small case letter or uppercase letter also. So first we are opening the file in read mode and next reading all the character, and it will be assigned to one by one in ch variable. And next we are comparing using in operator. We can check multiple character in a list using a in, or you can use double equal to symbol. So if it is present, means we are increasing the counting variable C. So after the loop, it will check whether C is not equal to 0, then it will be a present or not present. Another one method also we can follow, instead of read, we can read line by line, and next the line will be splitted into words using the function split. Next, the words will be assigned one by one to the variable w, and from the words, okay, it will be assigned to the letter one by one letter. For example, A means A first assigned, next M will be assigned to the variable letter. Next will be checked, and if it is present, count, or it won't count. If it is not equal to C is not equal to 0 means then it's present, otherwise it's not present. And next you are going to search the word am in the file first.txt. So we are reading the line and splitting the line into words and checking the words and increasing the counting variable. If it is not equal to 0 means it's present or not present. Using the read method also you can do the same things. Read all the character reads, afterwards you have to split into the words because you have to compare the words. So everything you have to split into the words, then you have to compare. Next, we are going to search the sentence which is start with am. We are going to check. Not am, sorry. We have to search that my. We have to search whether the sentence starts with my or not. So we have to read the lines, and here we have to split lines into words. So while we are splitting the lines into words, it will come like the list of strings. So next, list starting position start with 0 only, index position. So we are checking if words of 0 means the first position string in the list will be checked. So my capital or small, then it will be counted and it will show the present. And next, how many character present in that particular files we are going to check. We should not include the space, so we have to only count the letters in the greetings.txt file. So we are reading and splitting, and word will be assigned to the w variable one by one, and next from the word letter will be assigned one by one to the letter variable. And we are checking using the function is alpha function is used to check whether the string contains, this is a letter, is it alphabet or not. is digit for checking the number, is alpha checking for the alphabet, whether this letter is alphabet or not. If it is then it will be count, and total characters in the file is 42. And next we are going to count the word, how many he present in that first.txt, how many c present in the first.txt. So how to split the lines into words, and separate variable we are assigning for that c counting and he counting and checking. And if it is present, it will be increase the particular counting variable, and finally it will be displayed. Next, count how many lines present in the particular file, the first.txt we consider, and reading the lines, and just line alone we are taking one by one, and just we increase the counting variable, then we can get the number of lines in the particular file. And next we are going to modifications. See, in the same file we are going to modify data.txt file, you can consider, okay, pyton, okay, it is occurred in the four places wrongly, so we are going to change the data pyton instead of pyton. So here first open the file and reading all the data, and using the string function replace, it will be a replace all the occurrence in the pyton to pyton, just replacing only. So we have to once again we have to write, so open that same file and writing the same data, so all the replacing data will be assigned in the variable to data. So after closing that file, again open in write mode, and we have to write the data, then finally we can get the result, changed data we can see in that bottom of the screen. Next, replacing the string in one file and writing into that another file, okay, the same file data.txt, this content will be replaced, and then it will be written into the another one file. So reading mode open, data.txt open in the read mode, and the content after replacing the data will be write into the out.txt file. So we are reading line by line, and it will be replaced using the function replace. Next it will be written to the out.txt file. And next we are going to insert a line in between. So here consider the file business.txt. Here after good morning we are going to insert the good afternoon sentence. See, there are here two good morning sentence here. So what we have to do, we have to open business.txt file in read mode, and business inserted text file open in the write mode. So we are reading the line one by one, and it will be written into that business inserted text file. And next we are going to check if the good morning is present in the particular line. So we are reading line by line only, so if it is present means next we are going to insert it using the write function only, good afternoon slash and send, only it will go to the next line. See here, so this is start inserted text file. Now two times good afternoon is inserted after the good morning. And copying data from one file to another files. See, greetings.txt file content will be copied and pasted into greetings.1.txt file. So we are opening that greetings.txt in read mode and greetings.1 into write mode. Simply read by line by line, and it will be written into that another greetings.1.file using the f dot out dot write. Same content now copied into the greetings one, and removing the particular word. See, in this example we are going to see good word is removed from the greetings one. Note it. G is the capital. Okay, so the first good only going to remove. So using the same replace function, okay, we can remove that good is removed with the blank space. It's a single quotes. So what happened? Wherever the capital G O O D is present, it will be replaced by the blank space. And then the same file you are going to write the data. So now see that greetings.on.ast file. See the capital G O O D only. This is removed. And next, remove the line spaces. See here spaces.txt file. Every sentence after there is a line. So we are going to see how to remove the line. So open the file in read mode and read the lines. And we are assigning the empty list variable and empty string variable data. And read line by line using the for loop. LST functions used to remove the leading spaces in the particular line. If based on the arguments, see here the LST parenthesis, we don't give anything, so it consists a blank space, so it will be removed, and then it will be concatenated into the data variable. Next, it will be appended in the list variable using the function append. And next, here so multiple string, right, three sentences will be readed and appended with the list. So using the write lines functions only we can add the data. Now see that spaces will be removed. Thank you.